The song All Blues by the Miles Davis quintet from the Kind of Blue album. And I was like, wow, these guys are like art. You know, it's like the music was so much more just live and more human than anything I was listening to. You know, it's like that, at that time, it's like when something, like a fire within me almost, like a new thing that just surrounds me to this day. Every time I play, I envision like that type of stuff. You know, and ever since then, I've been carrying that on. You know, ever since Kenyon exposed me to that type of stuff, I've been carrying on with him. And I think one of the best things about Kenyon, that it's really tough to find in like a lot of instructors, unfortunately, is that he never stops learning. He's always trying, and he always knows what it means to work hard and get something out of it. You know, he's human just like the rest of us, even though he's like 6 foot forever, and you know, probably just glides off on his saxophone, but I mean, but you know, he really knows how to reach out to people, you know. And he's a great person, very, very humble, you know. If it wasn't for not just his skills on saxophone, but like his character and his aura, you know, it wouldn't have helped me out as far as my work, you know, as far as wanting to keep going. So that's why Kenyon Carter is one of the most inspirational people in my life. So thank you. And that song that you just heard, that was a Cross Current. That was an original of mine that I wrote back over the summer. Alright, the next song selection will be brought by another dear friend of mine, who was also very inspirational to me when I first came to JC. I was playing over, he might from Jacksonville, you know, this old bar restaurant named Waker. Used to be there. It's not there anymore, of course, but yeah, the jazz bands used to go down there and they used to jam out with a pizza and, you know, have a pretty good time. You know, that's my first time really getting exposed to combos. And there was like this one time, you know, where I was just like playing on some saxophone, and I think I was playing on alto actually. I was playing like all this smooth jazz, whatever, because I didn't know what that was. but then I see this guy walk in with this trumpet case, you know, and these like leather shoes all leathered out, like, oh, this guy must be Mr. Big Stuff. You know, walking in like Mr. Big Stuff. And you know, and I was like, oh man, I wonder how good this guy is. This guy gets on stage and starts playing licks like saxophonists would use. Because I mean, you know, people hear too many trumpet players, especially around here doing that type of stuff. This guy was really playing very soulful stuff. And it was from that moment when I was like, James with him. So I was like, wow, this guy is like something to really shoot for. Like, he is something that they really need in the community. And this guy is also a very positive community. He's helped out. He teaches that over at Aniston Middle School. Helps over at Aniston High School. You know, he contributes his time to the community. You know, he's helping me out with my recital. You know, he is a very humble guy, a very talented guy. I mean, the guy's a trumpet player, the guy's a saxophonist, a guitarist, a bassist, he does it all, you know. And I mean, photographer, DJ, all that type of stuff, you know. And because he's so inspirational to me, I'd like to introduce Tyson Hall to the stage. This is a... Just a minute. See, he plays so many instruments, he doesn't know which one to pick up. Cheat codes and like a video game and hits all the triple C's and stuff. But here we go. This is Cherokee. This is an old jazz standard from like, I think like 1930s or something. And probably before that. But this is an arrangement done by Kamasi Washington. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Excellent, excellent. How'd you like that guy? Yeah, I know he plays all the high notes. I think he just tries to imitate like the, you know, the way the dolphins like make signals with his swimming, and you know, I think he just gets all the way down. But his next tune is a tune I'm doing, this thing called I'm doing a soprano saxophone. It's like a lighter weight version of saxophone. What they basically did with the alto was, you know, somebody once dropped it like out of like a vehicle car or something like that. They just had to straighten it up, you know, and say, it still works. So here comes this friend. This next one is an original by mine as well, the Pocono. It's inspired by Afro-Cuban origins. You know, I mean, I'm pretty big on, you know, Afro-Cubanism. Afrocentrism. You know, I mean, look at this turtleneck. I mean, gosh, like, you know. But, you know, so I really wanted to, like, get back to that, those Afro roots with an Afro-Cuban piece. You know, so this next tune I'm going to play is called Coconut. Thank you.
Thank you.
that boy Leroy can play.